time in the history of the Republic, Kenya has ushered in a fertilizer manufacturing company, making it the fourth in Africa to be self-dependent on fertilizer production. Our reporter Willie Dennis Njiru visited the multi-billion shilling fertile plants East Africa factory in Nakuru County and filed the following report.
High decibels resembling that of drumming troops as the gears of this factory roll 24 hours a day is a big sigh of relief to Kenyan farmers who for decades have relied on fertilizers from Brazil, which at some point failed to meet their expectations.
We're going to be as competitive as any product brought in from any parts of the world. In terms of quality, we'll probably be even more superior to the quality that we get from abroad because ours is made specifically for this market.
With a possible capacity of 100,000 metric tons, over 2 million local farmers stand to benefit directly as Fatty Plants East Africa seek to close the gap between actual and attainable yield by incorporating science and technology in the production of tailor-made fertilizers.
You can put as much fertilizer as you want. You can buy 3, 4, 5 bags. You'll never get more yields. If you look at our maize yields and if you look at our sugar yields, if you look at our food deals generally, they've gone down because every year we think just by putting fertilizer we're helping ourselves or our plants. We are not. My message to the farmers is please, we haven't had extension services for a long, long, long period since the structural adjustment programs of the 1980s, but it is time farmers go. It doesn't cost much. Go and get your soils analyzed. Then you know that the formulation that you need.
The production shall be greatly informed by soil testing results so as to address soil nutrients deficiencies as well as crop nutrient requirements with expected yields of between 50 to 120% per acre.
We have to educate our farmers on the correct fertilizer formulation. Whether you're growing maize in Kakamega or you're growing maize in Trans Nzoia or in Kiambu, the farmers have to know the correct. It's not just buying a DAP or buying 777. It's good to know what's deficient in your soil, so you use the correct fertilizer formulation.
Coffee and tea farmers who have been adversely affected by the imported brands stand a high chance of better yields as the production shall factor soils in different regions.
We're going to start testing our tea formulation, which is 2655 with the option for 5 sulfur. Which also helps Kenya in terms of foreign exchange. Instead of every year us pleading for foreign importers to bring us 85,000 metric tons, the fundamentals change now because now the tea authority is more than welcome to come here.
Judy Wangeshi Njenga is a 2018 Woman Farmer of the Year from Ndabibi, Naivasha, who makes good her promise of better prices for food products in the shelves.
Tunafanya kilimo biashara. Kwa hivyo lazima tu compare fertilizer ya ngambo na hii ni gani yuko bei nafuu. Then tutaagusha chakula yetu na tutakuwa na product na chakula mingi yenye tutashibisha all over the world. Na tungeomba watufungulie baka account. Kama wewe ni mkulima unaenda unachukua fertilizer ukivuna then you pay them.
The COVID-19 pandemic has sent a warning that over-reliance on food and fertilizers from foreign countries can be costly and sometimes not forthcoming. Hence, the region could not be better prepared.
You know, with COVID, we have seen the risk of relying on foreign importations. It is time for us to really take that question seriously on food security, on what we can produce ourselves. As you all know, Africa spends nearly $40 billion every year importing food, not fertilizer, to feed her people.
Tangu COVID ikuja, tulikuwa na mashida mingi ya fertilizer, mara imefugiwa mara nini. Lakini kwa hii mambo, imetufusa kitu kubwa sana.
Reporting for TV 47 from Nakuru County, I'm Willie Dennis Njiru.